What if I told you that elegance has nothing to do with designer labels or perfectly coordinated outfits? Imagine wearing something as simple as a plain white tee and still being the most captivating person. Sounds impossible? It's not. Because true elegance is an energy, a magnetic force that has little to do with what you're wearing and everything to do with how you carry yourself. Stay with me, because by the end of this video, you'll see elegance in a whole new light. Number 1. Demeanor, the invisible halo. True elegance doesn't walk into a room shouting for attention. It's quieter and subtler, but infinitely more powerful. A calm, collected demeanor has a way of turning heads without trying. Think about it. Have you ever been around someone who instantly made you feel at ease, even in the most chaotic situation? That's elegance at work. Take Audrey Hepburn, for example. She didn't need loud statements or over-the-top gestures to leave an impression. Whether she was acting on screen or speaking about humanitarian causes, her calm composure was magnetic. People gravitated toward her, not because she demanded it, but because her presence created a sense of comfort and admiration. And here's the thing. Demeanor isn't just about how you handle yourself in good times. It's tested in those awkward moments we all dread. Like when you accidentally spill coffee on your blouse during an important meeting. Do you panic and fumble? Or do you laugh it off, clean up, and carry on? That graceful recovery, that ability to shrug off small embarrassments, is what sets truly elegant people apart. So, here's a little challenge for you. The next time life throws you a curveball, pause, breathe, handle it with grace, and watch how the world around you responds. You might just realize that your demeanor is your most powerful accessory. Number 2. Posture, a silent statement. Let's be real. There's something magnetic about a person with confidence. It's not about what they're wearing or even what they say. It's all about posture. Shoulders back, spine tall, head held high. Not stiff, not exaggerated, just assured. That's the kind of posture that says, I belong here. Think about Meghan Markle. She could be wearing a designer gown or a casual sweater, and yet her presence is undeniable. Why? Her posture does the talking. It's her silent statement that she's comfortable in her own skin. And that's the secret. It's not just about looking good. It's about feeling grounded and in control. Posture isn't just physical, it's psychological. When you stand tall, you feel more confident, and that energy radiates. It's an unspoken cue to the world that you're poised, elegant, and ready for anything. Here's a tip. Start practicing intentional movement in your daily life. Whether you're walking to grab a coffee or sitting at your desk, be aware of how you carry yourself. Relax your shoulders, elongate your spine, and move with purpose. It's not about being formal, it's about being present. Small adjustments can transform how you feel and how others see you. Number 3. Movements, grace in action. Have you ever noticed how someone can make even the simplest actions seem elegant? It's not about being theatrical or overly slow. It's about moving with intention. Graceful movements have this magical way of making everything feel elevated. Whether you're pouring a cup of tea, brushing a strand of hair out of your face, or setting your phone on the table, these small, seemingly mundane actions can reflect a sense of calm and elegance when done thoughtfully. Take Audrey Hepburn, for example. In Breakfast at Tiffany's, it wasn't just her outfits that made her iconic. It was the way she moved, the delicate way she held her cigarette holder, the way she sipped her coffee or glanced out the window. Every gesture was so deliberate, yet effortless. She didn't just wear elegance, she moved it. The secret is in avoiding abruptness. Rushed, jerky movements can feel chaotic, while calm, measured actions exude confidence. Try it for yourself. Next time you reach for something, slow down just a bit. Pay attention to your hands, your posture, and your breathing. It's not about being overly careful. It's about being present in the moment. Graceful movements speak volumes about your inner poise without you having to say a word. Number 4, the tone of voice. Your voice is like your personal soundtrack. It sets the mood for how people perceive you. And here's the thing, elegance isn't just what you wear or how you move, it's also how you sound. An elegant tone of voice is softer but never weak, confident but never overbearing. It's the balance of being firm without being forceful. Think about Princess Diana. In interviews, her voice wasn't loud or commanding, yet people hung on her every word. Why? Because she spoke with intention. Her calm, measured tone made you want to lean in and listen. That's the power of an elegant voice. It invites attention, rather than demanding it. Elegance in speech comes from clarity and kindness. It's about being thoughtful, both in what you say and how you say it. Avoid rushing or interrupting. Instead, practice slowing down, adding pauses, and lowering your pitch slightly. It gives your words weight and shows you're in control of the moment. And remember, it's not just about what you say, it's about how you make people feel when they hear you. A gentle, composed tone communicates respect, confidence, and grace, making your voice one of your most powerful tools for elegance. Number 5. Attention to others, the secret weapon. One of the most underrated markers of elegance is how much attention you give to others. Here's a truth bomb. Elegance isn't just about you, it's about how you make others feel. And one of the most underrated, yet most powerful markers of elegance is the attention you give to those around you. Genuinely elegant people know how to listen, not just nod along, but really listen. They make you feel like, in that moment, you're the most important person in the room. Think about the last time someone gave you their undivided attention. Not half-hearted glances or distracted nods, but real eye contact and thoughtful responses. Felt good, didn't it? That's what true elegance looks like in action. Audrey Hepburn exemplified this kind of elegance. Beyond her movie star looks, she dedicated her later years to UNICEF, traveling the world to help others. Her focus wasn't just on appearing elegant, it was on being elegant, making the world a better place and connecting with people in a meaningful way. Here's your takeaway. Pay attention to others. Put your phone down. Ask real questions and listen. Really listen. Elegance isn't about being the center of attention. It's about making others feel like they are. Number 6. The elegance of simplicity. Sometimes the most elegant thing you can do is nothing at all. Think about it. True elegance often thrives in simplicity. It's the small, effortless gestures that leave the biggest impact. A genuine smile, for example, can outshine even the most intricate outfit. There's something undeniably powerful about someone who knows how to just be, without trying too hard. Take a look at the world's most elegant people, and you'll notice something interesting. They rarely over-accessorize. No extravagant jewelry, no heavy makeup, just clean lines and simple pieces that allow their natural beauty and confidence to speak for themselves. It's not about cluttering the look, it's about letting your inner grace shine through. This applies to interactions as well. Elegant people don't need to be loud or boastful to make an impact. They don't have to impress, they just are. They're not trying to be anything they're not, and that's exactly what makes them magnetic. Their simplicity disarms, and their authenticity draws people in. It's the kind of elegance that doesn't scream for attention, it quietly commands it. So, here's a tip. Don't overcomplicate things. Whether in your wardrobe or your interactions, keep it simple. Let your confidence and presence do the heavy lifting. You might just find that the more you embrace simplicity, the more elegant you become. So, there you have it. Elegance isn't just about what you wear, but how you move, speak, and treat the people around you. It's a way of being, not a way of looking. The truth is, you don't need a designer wardrobe or the perfect outfit to be elegant. What you need is to carry yourself with intention and embrace the beauty in simplicity. When you focus on the way you interact with the world and the way you make others feel, That's when true elegance shows up. If you enjoyed this, don't forget to like, subscribe, and share your thoughts in the comments below. What's your personal take on elegance? Let's keep this conversation going. Thanks for watching, and remember, elegance is all about being you in the most graceful way possible.